Now that we know how to name double bonds, there's an extra complication that we have to consider, which is that double bonds, because of the lack of free rotation, are going to be able to arrange themselves in different ways. So now we have to take into account not only the fact that there's a double bond and it has priority, but we're also going to have to take into account the arrangement of that double bond. So let's go ahead and get started. So I'm sure you've heard of the word cis and trans before. Cis and trans are names given to particular arrangements of double bonds or of rings. Okay? So basically, anytime that you have no free rotation, okay, you're going to have the possibility for cis and trans. So for example, a double bond, if two groups are oriented in the same position, remember that a double bond is pretty, like, has a lot of regions of overlap, so it can't twist out of shape. So that means the double bond is stuck there. In the same way, a ring has the same problem, where if I, for example, have a ring that looks like this, and then I have a group facing up, and I also have another group facing up. So notice that this is like a 3D structure. Let's say this is one atom and another atom. See how they're both facing the same way? I can't actually rotate this one to the down position without breaking the ring, because that ring, in order to move one down, it would have to snap. So this is, cis and trans are the words that we use for these arrangements that are stuck together, okay? And like I said, these isomers exist because free rotation around pi bonds is impossible. Okay? So basically the way that that this works is that when two groups happen to be on the same side of the fence, okay, I'm gonna talk about what that is in a second. When they're on the same side, that's gonna be cis. When they're on different sides of the fence, that's gonna be trans. So what kind of mysterious fence am I talking about? Well, let's say we have a double bond. The way that I like to split it up is I like to draw a dotted line right through the middle of the double bond. Okay? So that double bond is my fence, all right? And then what I say is, how are these groups related to each other on that double bond? So for example, if I wanted to compare A and C, are they on the same side of the fence or different sides? Well, they're both on the same side. They're both on the top side. So the relationship between A and C would be cis. What about the relationship between B and C? What would that relationship be? Well, those are on different sides, so that one would be trans. Okay, got that so far? How about the relationship between A and B? How about if I were to say, what kind of relationship is that? Okay? A and B actually don't have a cis and trans relationship. The reason is because they're on the same carbon, okay? Cis and trans only applies to atoms on other carbons, not on ones that are on your own carbon. So A and B would actually get a completely different type of name that we're not going to discuss here, but it wouldn't have to do with cis and trans. So cis and trans only has to do with the way that one atom to another relates to, okay? Like the ways that these relate to each other, okay? So here I've got two different versions of 2-butene. When I say that, you shouldn't be shocked. You should know what I'm talking about, because that means that's a butane with a double bond in the 2 position. Easy, okay? But these are not both the same molecule. In fact, they're gonna have different physical properties. They're going to behave differently and stuff like that. So what would be the names that we would give to these to show that they're distinctly different? The names that we would give would be, well, I would draw my fence and I would say, okay, are these on the same side of the fence or different? Same. So this one would be cis-2-butene. And then this one would be trans-2-butene. All right? And these are, later on we're going to talk about them, there's something called stereoisomers, which means that they actually are connected the same way, but they're shaped differently. But for right now, just know that these are molecules that are locked in their position and they can't move.